Welcome to the RFP Success Show with host Lisa Rehurick, the number one sought-after authority on RFP success. Each week, we bring you information, strategies, or resources to help you win more business through RFPs and have a little fun doing it. Let's get this week's episode started.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the RFP Success Show. I am your host, Lisa Rehurick, founder and CEO of the RFP Success Company. And I'm so excited to introduce you today to Sherry Fisher. Sherry is actually a new employee of the RFP Success Company. She's our new project and operations director, and she's got a health and fitness background. And the reason that I wanted her to be on here is because there's a lot of stress that is associated with the type of work that we do in proposals and responding to RFPs. And there's a lot of times that we don't necessarily take care of ourselves, or we don't know how to manage that stress, or we don't even pay attention to managing the stress. So we wanted to have a conversation today about what we can do to stay healthy and manage our stress when we're in positions like this that are all over the place and that are not structured and that are not consistent. So that's why she's here today. I'm very excited. So welcome, Sherry.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Absolutely. So before we kick it off and get into the meat of it, why don't you do a little bit of an introduction? Tell us about your background and where you came from and just a little bit more about you.
Sure. Yeah. So I have been in the fitness industry for quite a while in different environments, from commercial gyms to community parks and rec. And then for the last decade or so have been in corporate fitness. So dealing with people in, you know, bigger companies, stressful jobs, and helping them put movement into their day. Also doing, you know, different programs around nutrition or stress management for those employees to give them, you know, a better overall well-being.
Yeah. I love it. And, you know, it's interesting because Sherry, I've known Sherry for a long time. And, you know, I've had my own health challenges and becoming an entrepreneur about, you know, 9 years ago now, and being much more sedentary in my own business, in my own office, and the tips that she's given me. And then with her coming on board, just some of the things that we've talked about, because I've had some health challenges myself with the type of work that I do. So I think this is going to be a really fun conversation. So yay.
Yeah. And you make a big, good point about being more sedentary, you know, having all this great technology that we have right in our, days, in our offices now, that we don't really have to go anywhere. We can sit in one spot and we can be connected to people all over the world, and we don't really need to get up and move anymore. And that all day being sedentary is really taking a toll on our society. And yeah, kind of one of the big stats I always like to put out there is that they're calling sitting the new smoking now. So smoking was always the worst thing you could do for yourself, and now they're saying our sitting is. And what was staggering to me is what they were saying is if somebody works out an hour a day, 7 days a week, but is sedentary the rest of the time, that is not enough to counteract
Wow.
all the hours of sitting. So even if you think you're good, like getting that hard workout in, if you're really just kind of sitting all day, there's really adverse effects to your health on that.
Yeah. And I believe it. And you know, it's so funny. Mm-hmm. And I know that a lot of our listeners will be able to relate to this, because I even, you know, there's things that I've put into place. I've got a standing desk in my office. So I've got a sitting desk, and then I've got another standing desk. And I just bought this really cool thing called Fluid Stance, where it's kind of like this balance board that you stand on. And, you know, I just forget to actually get up and use those things sometimes, because I get so into the proposal that we're working on. Or I'll say, okay, in 30 minutes when I finish this call, then I'll get up and do it. And I find myself forgetting to do that. So with that, like, what are some ways people can, I know that sounds so dumb, but how can people help themselves remember to do that kind of stuff?
I know it is, you know, like anything, the more you do it, the more it's in your head to do it, right? So one of the big things is just trying to listen to the signs, or, you know, don't ignore the signs that your body's giving you. Do you start to feel achy and stiff? Do you keep adjusting in your chair? No position that you get into is comfortable. You cross your leg, you're uncross your leg. You're shifting side to side. You're slouching a little bit. That's a sign that your body is saying, get up and move.
Yes.
So one thing is just be aware of that, and then use that as a sign like, okay, at least when I start doing that and feeling that way, I'm going to get up and move. There's also reminders out there. There's desktop reminders that you can find on the internet to put reminders, you know, on your on your desktop that will pop up.
Like my Apple Watch does that, but I don't always wear my Apple Watch.
Right? Yeah. Now people have all the activity watches that will, you know, buzz you like, hey, you haven't been standing enough or moving enough.
Yeah. Which is so really kind of cool.
Yeah. I mean, use those reminders and, you know, a lot of them, there's different ones that have different features out there. Some of them will just do a little pop-up just to say, hey, get up and move. There's one that's called Desk Fit that actually gives you random activities to do, which is kind of fun. You can choose your activities. So it's something different each time you get up, and you can change different lengths of time. You know, even just, you know, doing something for 2 minutes is helpful.
Yeah, I love that idea. And, you know, the next question that I was going to ask you, which we're already kind of talking about, is, you know, for those of us that do sit at our desk all day, what are some things that we can do to keep ourselves from getting so sedentary? And so we've talked about a few already, and I love that desktop app. And I remember the last time we talked about it that I was like, I need to put that on my desktop. And of course, I haven't done it yet, but I'm going to. What other things can we do to make sure that we're not so sedentary?
Yeah, just trying to find opportunities where you can move. When you start becoming more aware and looking for those opportunities, you'll find that there's more out there than you think. So, you know, in the business area aspect, you know, if you're on a call, can you stand while you're on that call? Sometimes, you know, we're on calls that we really don't have to participate much, but we have to listen. Can you go and sit against the wall and do a wall squat while you're listening?
That's a great idea.
Just standing up at your desk and lifting up your knees. If you're reading a document, stand up and do some squats or lift your legs out to the side, alternating or kicking back. You know, just find opportunity to move your body. We're not talking about having to be, you know, just thinking about hard exercise. We're just talking about daily movement.
Yeah. And it's so funny how it does sound so simple, right? It's like, we're just talking about daily movement and how easy it is to kind of get out of that. And so for those of you that are young listening to this, that's probably easy for you. But as we get older, I feel like it just becomes easier to just sit around and not do as much. And you forget that that's what's happening. And then you kind of fall into that trap. What are some other ways for people to stay healthy? So, you know, we've been talking about movement, but it's not just about movement. When you're in a stress-induced job that is inconsistent, your lunch hours probably get blown up a whole bunch, you work super long days. What are some ways that people should be thinking about to stay healthy in that type of a job?
Yeah, great question. We talked about the movement. So probably I would say three key things are, yes, our movement, nutrition, and sleep. So nutrition, we think of what type of fuel are we putting in our body, basically, right? So are we fueling ourselves to operate like a well-oiled machine? When you think of a car, you want to put the good oil in your car and make sure it's got gas. So we take care of our cars so they run properly. It's the same thing with our body. So, you know, if we're putting crap in our body, then we're not feeling
crap
it,
in,
right?
Crap so, out.
Yeah, right. So, yeah, exactly. So we want to put, you know, and, you know, I'm always kind of say, like, if you can go with that 80-20 rule. So 80% of the time, if you're putting good fuel sources into your body, you know, we're going to be healthier and manage stress better and so forth. And then sleep. People underestimate the amount of sleep. I feel in our society, we kind of go through this, I'm cool because I only need 4 hours of sleep. Or
yeah, it's like
I'm
a badge
cool
of honor.
Because, yes, it's a badge of honor. And I'm like, no. I mean, when we are sleeping, that is our time for our body to recharge. It's fixing and repairing things. So, you know, so we stay healthy. So our immune system stays strong. The more, you know, our body can do that overnight, the less we're going to get sick, the more we're going to be able to manage stress.
Mm. And is it true that everybody's different with the amount of sleep that they need, or is it more like a really everybody needs at least 8 hours?
Yeah. For adults, they say 7 to 9 hours,
okay,
you know, is average. You know, you will get people that just say, oh no, I only need 4, but
yeah.
Okay. Maybe they think they only need 4, but people don't realize what's going on in their body overnight, that it needs that time to regenerate and repair in our body. So they might feel alert and like, no, I'm good on 4 hours. It's not about that. It's about all the stuff that your body has to do in that time. So that's where I think people think, oh yeah, I only need that amount. So they really recommend 7 to 9 hours is the time for adults that we need for our body to do everything it needs to do overnight.
I love that point too. I love the point of, you know, it's not just about how energetic we are the next day or how we feel like revitalized. It's about our bodies being able to repair. That's huge. And then also it feels like if we do that over too much time, that could build up a whole lot of other bad stuff if we're just doing like 4 hours a night.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, because your body's not having time to go through all the processes it has to. So again, the biggest things you see are, you know, illnesses and not dealing with stress well. Those are probably two key things when you don't let your body really heal overnight.
Yeah. Okay, so let's talk about food a little bit. You brought that up as one of the three. And I know for me, if I if I avoid food for too long in the day, which today is a perfect example, it's 3 o'clock, 3:30 in the afternoon my time, and I ate breakfast. So now I'm starving. And now I'm probably, you know, now I'm more inclined to make bad choices for my meal that I eat next. And so what are some tips that you would give us to avoid this when sometimes it feels unavoidable?
Yeah, it's true. I mean, obviously the number one thing we always recommend is to meal prep and just have something ready to go, because your day is already busy. And if you have to stop and even take time to make something, that's even less likely that you're going to eat. So at least if you have something already made, you just pull it out and eat it. Right.
Yep.
So yeah, there's a lot, and there's a lot of things that just you can, you know, you don't have to spend a lot of time meal prepping. Just chop some stuff, cook some stuff. You know, usually if on a Sunday I can do I can do breakfast and lunch for 5 days in about an hour, hour and a half. So you can do some pretty
quick
stuff.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. But sometimes we have those things and we still don't eat, right?
Yeah.
So, you know, it's trying to, you know, what are those things? Okay, then maybe I'm not going to get that meal that I have prepped in the refrigerator, but I've got these nuts I can eat.
Yeah.
And, you know, what are some quick things you can have at your desk that, okay, my stomach is growling and I can't think of anything else right now, but I'm still working, but my stomach's growling. And at least have those, you know, kind of quick, healthy snacks that, I mean, really, we can't take 5 minutes to stop and eat something.
Yeah. I know, it's ridiculous, right? And to your point, I think too that, you know, your stomach starts growling, it's uncomfortable, you're thinking about it. There's no